everybody doing? This is it. Please join me in welcoming some of my favorite musicians in the world, one of the bands, and starting out with our wonderful vibraphonist, ladies and gentlemen. How about it for the great Pete Miller? Pete Miller on vibraphone. Metro Detroit's own leader of the new generation of jazz, ladies and gentlemen. Wonderful band leader, composer, and arranger in his own right. How about it for the fantastic Marcus Elliott? We appreciate you coming out and fellowshipping with us this evening and enjoying this music. And we know you could have been anywhere, but you chose to be with us, and we truly appreciate it. And we'd like to let you know that we know what we're going to play, we just don't know how we're going to play. So that's where you come in. And we're going to be feeding off of your love, your energy, and spirit. The notes that we play on stage, these are your notes, never be played the same way again. So ladies and gentlemen, let's take this journey together. Is that all right? Our first song was a West Montgomery composition titled Jingles. We're playing some songs off of our latest recording, The Journey, and we're going to continue with the Donald Byrd composition entitled Fancy Free. I will tell you, ladies and gentlemen, this is the quietest I've ever heard the Blue Mountain in my life. Everything all right? Feel free to be in the spirit. We are not at the public library. We're not in the back of your classroom. Marcus says we are not at the dentist. You may speak your mind. We'd like to let you know, ladies and gentlemen, if you have a request of any kind, any song that you would like to hear, please write it down on the back of a $50 or $100 bill, and we'd be happy to play it. And if you do request a tune, and we don't know it, we'll play another song with the exact same notes in it. Is that all right? Sit back and relax. Enjoy your food. Enjoy your drink. Enjoy the Blue Mama Jazz Club, ladies and gentlemen. This is Fancy Free. Thank you.
Thank you.
so much. Thank you so much. You guys having a good time so far?
Yeah.
All right. I think we'd like to take this opportunity and put the spotlight on our wonderful saxophonist, Big Marcus Elliott. Marcus is a professor at Wayne State University, as well as the University of Michigan. He also leads his own ensembles, his own groups, and he's teaching everywhere, and he's really spreading the word of this music. So we're really happy to have him with us. And so we'd like to feature him on a tune of his choice. This was his idea. I'd like to remind you that if you do not like this next song, please give all suggestions and comments to Marcus Elliott. This is his idea that we played. I didn't want to do it, but he was upset. I'm only serious. All right, ladies and gentlemen. So we're going to continue the tune off of our record. It's a tune entitled Willow Weep For Me. It's a feature of the great Marcus Elliott.
Thank you.
on the saxophone. Let the church say amen.
Amen,
amen again.
Amen.
We'd like to continue service, ladies and gentlemen, and put the spotlight on our wonderful organist. He's an unbelievable musician, and it's hard for me to believe that now I used to be the young guy on the bandstand, and now, I'll just say, now I'm not. and I'm like, how old are you, man? And man, well, anyway, so goodness. So yeah, it goes quick. That's all I can say. Long days, short years. That's all I can say. But this young man is only 25 years old. He's an unbelievable player. Yeah, and along with his talents, he wants to continue the tradition and take the music forward. And so he's also in school to be an educator. So we're really excited about that. And part of the organ tradition is that it has to be handed down to you from some of the mentors and some of the musicians that come before you, the great organists that come before you. And Cliff has the honor of being passed the baton by all the great veteran organists in our area that they believe in his talent, and they're relying on him to continue music forward. So with your indulgence, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to put the spotlight on our wonderful organist at this time and offer you a Dr. Lonnie Smith composition. And this is a tune entitled The Witch Doctor. We hope you like it. Clean up on aisle 5. No, stay there, Jake. Can you just turn the stage volume up a little bit for me? One out on 12, yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Chris Metcalf on organ, ladies and gentlemen. Chris Metcalf, ladies and gentlemen. You guys still having a good time out there? All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to, we're just rehearsing at your expense, by the way. We'd like to turn the spotlight now on our wonderful vibraphonist. Believe it or not, I've known him since he was shorter than me. That's a true statement. Or were you?
I think at one point.
I met him when he was 4 years old, ladies and gentlemen. So, I met our vibraphonist, and I got a phone call from his private teacher, and I was running an after-school youth program at the time, and he says, well, he's like, I've got this really talented musician, and wonderful, and he's really, really into it, and but he wants to play everything, and I think he'd be good for your program. So I said, well, tell him to choose an instrument and give me a call. You know, he wants to play everything. And so he shows up, and he decided he wanted to be a drummer. And he sounded just like Buddy Rich and Billy Cobham all together, man. He was like talented. And I was like, oh, this is scary. And then he decided he didn't like the drums anymore. I think that's because he had to pack them up the first time. I gotta stay 2 hours after everybody else. I don't like this. So he then moved on and decided he wanted to be a jazz piano player. And I was like, okay, that's cool. He sounded like Herbie Hancock and Oscar Peterson all together, man. I couldn't believe it. So talented. Then he decided, I don't like the piano anymore. Then he wanted to be an organist. He played jazz organ for a while. Sounded just like Groove Holmes, Dr. Lonnie Smith, and Joey DeFrancesco all together, man. He had it all down together. And it was like, I don't like the organ anymore. Then he decided he's going to pick up the vibraphone, and I think he found his home, ladies and gentlemen. I think he found it. So this is his feature in the band. And this is kind of our band's theme song, and we'd like to let you know, fellas in the audience, this is known as the Time Life How to DIY talk to your lady. Some of y'all remember Time Life books, but that's all right, and that just proves my age, but that's cool. So these lyrics are hip. Y'all want me to sing to you? What? Raise your hand if you want me to sing these lyrics. For those of you who agree that I should sing, why would you agree to something like that? So, here's how we're going to do this. For those of you who agree that I should sing this song, your cover charge now is free. But we're going to charge you to leave. No, ladies and gentlemen, these are some beautiful lyrics. This is a James Ingram composition. And I love these lyrics. Compliment what she does. Send her roses just because. If it's violin she loves, let them play. Dedicate her favorite song and hold her close all night long. Love her today, 5 in 100 ways. Hey, there's some lyrics, ladies and gentlemen. You know what I'm saying? See how I can say my nap sending those out to you? So we're gonna turn this. Yeah, man, sound like a Cadillac. All right, so we're gonna put the spotlight on our wonderful vibraphonist. And we'd like to remind you, fellas, the minute that you hear us count this tune off, lean over to your lady and tell her it was your idea that we played this tune that you requested. We will stay up on the bandstand for 15 or 20 minutes to corroborate your story. This is what's known in music as an alley-oop. Best wishes to you. All right, here we go. Thank you.
Nate Miller.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're just about time to conclude our show. We have just a couple of more songs for you. Guys having a good time so far?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we would like to take this opportunity. We're going to perform something off of our latest record, The Journey. And we'd like to take this opportunity to take you on vacation, ladies and gentlemen. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Well, unfortunately, we live on a musician's salary. So we can't take you on a real vacation, we're going to take you on a mental vacation. Is that okay? All right. This is a Victor Feldman composition, and this tune is entitled Rio. We hope you like it. Thank you.
I
saxophone. How about it for the great Marcus Elliott? We'd also like to remind you that you haven't had enough jazz, and how can you ever have enough jazz, right? You can't ever have enough jazz. The great Peyton Miller and Marcus Elliott will be here tomorrow night with Peyton's debut as a band leader, ladies and gentlemen. He will be right on the stage tomorrow night. Come support him. Speaking of never having enough jazz, ladies and gentlemen, can we please recognize a celebrity in the audience? She is responsible for keeping jazz alive right here in our community on public radio, WEMU. The great Molly Motherwell is in the house, ladies and gentlemen. Please recognize her for her. Also, please recognize the fifth member our band. You don't see him, but he's responsible for the groove, vibe, and spirit. Without him, we cannot do what we do. Our wonderful sound man, Jacob's in the back, ladies and gentlemen. Please join us. And please, 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 it is a team effort. It is a team effort to bring the spirit, the love, and the music with you to you, ladies and gentlemen, right here on the stage. It's about the team, so I want to recognize and please, please applaud for our wonderful wait staff, Chef Jorge, and his culinary experts, and our wonderful bar staff, ladies and gentlemen. Please show us some love. And also, when you walked into the door, you were greeted by a beautiful, bright smile. Isn't that right, ladies and gentlemen? That's right. Somebody better applaud. That's my opinion. That's my beautiful daughter, Layla, as the host lady. We'd like to remind you, this is your first time here at the Blue Llama Jazz Club. Please don't let it be your last. This is the greatest club in the world for jazz entertainment. If you can't come back next time, please send a friend in your place, all right? We'd also like to remind you, we have to keep this club going. Every time you come here, you're making an investment in the artist, and you're making an investment in the future of the arts right here in your community, ladies and gentlemen. So it's important that we continue to come out and support the club. Put it on your calendar once a month. Support the establishment. Now, it does not have to be the Sean Dobbins Morgan Quartet, as long as it's hardcore Blue Llama Jazz. All right, ladies and gentlemen? Last but not least, your host that loves you the most. Actually, before I announce myself, ladies and gentlemen, see how I can just talk to audibles like that? I need to work with the lions. That's another discussion. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a couple other celebrities in the audience, and I love doing this because every time I say that, people try to look around on the slide to see if they can recognize them. Like, we got some celebrities. Ladies and gentlemen, a couple of important people are here, and you don't know them, but I do. So they make some celebrities, all right? They're celebrities, and I would just like to recognize my two brothers from another mother that's in the audience, and they came out to hear us, ladies and gentlemen. And I want you to understand the importance of friendship. I've been friends with these guys
for 45.
I've been best friends. Gracious Lord. Whoa. Been best friends with these guys for 35 years, ladies and gentlemen. 35 years of best friends. See you, Kevin Hart. He's like, So you know when you're lucky enough, you know, sometimes you're good and you have some you have some good friends, but then sometimes the Lord blesses you with great friends for life, and that's what I have, ladies and gentlemen. So I don't have much money, but I'm a rich man because of my people that are around me. So I just want to recognize my peoples that are here. My main man, Mikey, right here, and his beautiful wife, Desiree, my sister's in the house. My other main man, Brian, over here, his wonderful wife, Teresa. And quickly, ladies and gentlemen, it takes a village to raise a child, and it took three villages to raise us. We were tough, it was wrong, but it is what it is. And so my second mother is here. This is Diane Wright is over here, ladies and gentlemen. As well as my surrogate aunt and uncle, ladies and gentlemen, we travel with Tony, his beautiful wife Shelly, ladies and gentlemen. So I'm really honored to have family and friends here with me tonight. If you're lucky to have some family and friends that come on, I'm really honored. I appreciate y'all coming out, seriously. And I know I told you I paid for y'all, but that was just to get you here. So ladies and gentlemen, last but certainly not least, your host that loves you the most on the drums and cymbals. If you do not like the way that I play, my name is Buddy Rich, ladies and gentlemen. If you do, my name is Sean Dobbins. Thank you very much. We're going to break this up before he breaks us down, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a pleasure to perform for you. We look forward to seeing you again and again and again and again in the near future. On behalf of the band, sincerely, from the depths of our hearts, may God bless you. May God keep you. Ladies and gentlemen, good night. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Jazz Club. We are small, but we are mighty. Please join me in welcoming some of my favorite musicians on the planet to the bandstand. Starting out with our wonderful vibraphonist, ladies and gentlemen. How about it for the greats? Peyton Miller, ladies and gentlemen. Peyton Miller. Our soprano and tenor saxophonist, the great Marcus Elliott, ladies and gentlemen. Marcus Elliott. Thank you.
Your mother is Ella Dillard on the saxophone.
You guys having a good time so far?
Yeah!
All right. Well, based off of your energy, we're going to continue.
Woo!
And we'll take it up just a notch to the businessman's bounce. And this is a tune that I recently recorded on my Trio record, the Trio Files. And so I'm going to offer you this composition. And this tune is entitled Juicy Lucy. We hope you like it. Thank you. Spotlight on our wonderful organist, ladies and gentlemen, and he is part of the tradition of the organ. It has to be passed down to you by some of the masters and the veterans, and he has been trusted by the great legendary Metro Detroit jazz organist as someone that will be respected and is expected to continue the organ tradition, ladies and gentlemen. And so he's done the work. And it's unbelievable how old he is. It's tough. I have kids his age. And his, by the way. So it is what it is. I don't know what he's done, how he's done it in this small amount of time, but he's made it happen, ladies and gentlemen. So with your indulgence, we'd like to turn a spotlight on the great Cliff Metcalf. And we'd like to perform a tune written by the great organist Dr. Lonnie Smith. And we thought we'd offer you a little back track, if that's all right, ladies and gentlemen. This is back track.
Thank you.
How about for the great Cliff Metcalf, ladies and gentlemen? And we're going to turn the stage over and feature our wonderful vibraphonist. And he's just an unbelievable musician. And great composer, great arranger. And he's also an excellent band leader. And he's such a great band leader, he will be leading his own group here tomorrow night. Tomorrow night. He'll be joined by the great Marcus Elliott, Ben Smirner. Brandon Rose, and one of the great, great young drummers coming up, the great David Alvarez III. So he's going to have a great band with him, and it's really his time to shine, and we're so proud of him for earning this opportunity and playing so well. And so I know you live in Ann Arbor, Michigan, it's impossible to have enough jazz, right? You can't have enough. So to make your reservations, if you haven't already, come right back out tomorrow and come hear the great Pink Mill. You're going to have a great show. But we're going to, yes, please, come back out. Bring your friends. And so we're going to slow things down here and offer you a beautiful ballad. Is that all right, ladies and gentlemen? All right. And this is one of my favorite tunes, and all of our favorite tunes that we want to dedicate this to. We lost one of our great composers. We're talking about the great Burt Bacharach. He just recently passed away. And so we wanted to honor his memory, perform this tune, and selfishly, my wife is in the audience. So I want to make sure I play a song for my beautiful wife, who's right here at this table with my beautiful daughters, right here, my wife, Lula. Every time she's in the audience, I always want to play a song for her. Greatest thing I ever did was get married to my wife. Greatest decision I ever made in my life. Absolutely. So I always want to play a tune for her. And so, fellas, I'd like to remind you at this point, when we begin this tune, feel free to whisper in your significant other's ear and let her know that it was your idea that we actually play this tune. And yeah, and then we stay on the stage for 15 minutes after the show and corroborate your story and say, yes, it was actually his idea. So you're gonna hear me start to play some brushes here in a minute. It's got a nice soft sound, and at that moment is when you lean over and say, I requested this for you, man. Works every time. So we're going to slow things down and feature the great Peyton Miller. This is a beautiful tune by the late, great Burt Bacharach. This is dedicated to my wife and all you wonderful couples here this evening. It's a tune entitled, This Guy's in Love with You. We hope you like it.
Miller on the vibraphone, ladies and gentlemen. Woo-hoo! And
Miller.
And we got time for a couple more tunes. We're going to put the spotlight on our wonderful tenor and soprano saxophonist, the great Marcus Elliott. And Marcus currently teaches at Wayne State University. As well as the University of Michigan, right down the street. And he deserves a special round of applause because he and his wife are now enjoying a two-year-old son. He'll be two next week, ladies and gentlemen. So he's a special round of applause for him. And he's such an important part of the community. Wonderful. Wonderful educator, and he's a wonderful mentor to the musician that's coming behind him. Actually, one of his students is right here. Elvin Sharp is right here. One of his students is here. And Marcus is doing a great job of continuing the legacy of mentorship right here in Metro Detroit. So we're so proud of him, and we'd like to put the spotlight on him right now. And he doesn't know what I'm going to call. This is the cool thing about this.
Get him.
Yeah.
One, two,
yeah. Maybe cut out.
You got it.
We'll take it up just a notch, ladies and gentlemen, and we're going to perform a tune off of our record. Actually, I'm going to let you choose it. So, right now the band is up for raises right now, so Marcus just asked if we can play the tune that I wrote. Okay. Strategically, I love it. Okay, so we're going to continue with this tune that's the title track off of our recording, The Journey, and this will feature the great Marcus Elliott. We hope you enjoy. This is The Journey.
One, two, three, four.
Zoe.
Y'all enjoying yourselves? Okay, we're going to offer you just a couple more, two more tunes really quick. All right, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to offer you a brief tune here, and is it okay if we offer you one more original composition? Is that all right? Wait. Is it still okay if it's written by the drummer, though? All right. It gets sensitive now because, you know, it could be like one note, a 20-minute drum solo, and then that's another note. So, you know, people don't always like that. So, all right. Well, I'm going to offer you a tune. And this is off of our upcoming record, and we will be definitely doing our release right here at the Blue Llama Jazz Club when this record comes out. There's no other place I want to be. We're going to do our record release right here. And this is off of our upcoming record entitled All Lives Stand Up. And it's really a look at what's happening in our world and a look inside each other to really understand and reflect on our own humanity and how do we come together through problems, trials and tribulations, and things that we're all dealing with, no matter what our background, and how do we come together through those things. And one of the tunes that I wrote is a tune I'm thinking about. I have three children. Two of my girls are over here right now, my grown adult girls. And, one of the things that I'm realizing with my kids growing up, my other son, he's 19 years old, and I'm realizing that, like, we're trying to tell them, you know, how they need to look at the world, and they're trying to tell us the world that they feel like they're going into, and that's the tough part. And my thing was, like, how do we figure out a way to create that communication path so that we as our generation understand how to help them into the world that they see, but they're also able to accept the wisdom that will make them successful in that world. We're trying to bridge that gap, and that's something that we can all talk about and all try to help the next generation, but it's up to us to kind of understand where they're coming from in the world that they see in their eyes and try to help them in that. So this is the tune, it's up to us to figure it out. So, this is the tune, we hope you like this one. And I wrote this one thinking about my own kids and everybody else's kids and stuff. So, hope you like this one. This is entitled Generations.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, before we leave the bandstand, I would like to acknowledge our own special celebrity who's in the audience this evening. And I am talking about the person, the first person or the second person, but first person that I was really looked at and looked in her eyes, and she completely changed my life forever. And I was trying to figure out how I was going to make this work and just try to be the best example, best everything I can be for her so that she has the greatest life that she can possibly have. And I am so proud of the adult, the person, the human, her humanity, her love for people, her love for everything. And I just want to take a moment and acknowledge that in just a couple of days, it is my beautiful daughter's birthday. My daughter Rima is right over here. And we have a little birthday candle for my daughter. So we're going to say on the count of three, happy birthday, Rima. She blew out her candle. One, two, three. Happy birthday. My daughter's 23 years old now, so I'm so proud of her. I couldn't be more proud of her than everything she's doing. She just graduated from college last year. She's working at U of M Hospital, and she's, you know, the cool thing, all of my kids have a different vibe, but my oldest, when she was 9 years old, I realized she was smarter than me. And she's like really into reading, and I just realized like she had way more knowledge. So I was like, well, I guess with this one, I'm just going to have to take more of a supportive role than just hang in and give her a little advice here and there. But I've been talking to her about stuff, and I'm thinking like your dad, like you're giving him some knowledge, like, come here, daughter, you know. Yes, actually, I know what that happened. And she started telling me something like, oh, real? So I get on my notepad and have to take notes when she's talking. So she's my beautiful daughter. I'm so proud of you, sweetie. I love you so much. And thank you for being my daughter. Great Peyton Miller, ladies and gentlemen. On the organ, Cliff Metcalf, ladies and gentlemen. Tenor and soprano saxophone, the Marcus Elliott. Just a reminder, come back tomorrow to hear Peyton Miller and Marcus Elliott. Peyton's going to lead his band, so make sure you come on back out, ladies and gentlemen. Come on right back out. Make it a weekend. Just come stay at the Blue Mama all weekend. Just make it a weekend, all right? Just come on right back out. The fifth member of our band, ladies and gentlemen, you don't see him, but he's responsible for the groove, vibe, and spirit. Without him, we cannot do what we do. Our wonderful sound man, Jacob, is right in the back, ladies and gentlemen. Please join us along. And please, 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 please recognize our wonderful culinary experts, our wonderful wait staff, and our wonderful bar staff. Please recognize them right now. Last but not least, you were greeted by a wonderful, warm, sparkling smile at the door when you came in. And that is my daughter, Layla, who is the hostess here, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming out. Thank you for spending this time. Thank you for fellowshipping with you. You could have been anywhere, but you chose the Blue Mama Jazz Club to spend your evening, and we appreciate it. And every time you come here, you're investing in the artists, you're investing in the arts, you're investing in young people like Elvin to have a place to play, and this is a whole community movement, so we hope to keep it going. And I ask you, ladies and gentlemen, put the Blue Mama on your calendar once a month. Support the establishment. It does not have to be the Sean Dobbins Orchid Quartet, as long as it's hardcore Blue Mama Jazz. All right, ladies and gentlemen? Last but not least, your host that loves you the most on the drums and cymbals. If you do not like the way that I play, my name is Billy Cobham. If you do, my name is Sean Dobbins. Thank you very much. We're going to take you home with a little Stevie Wonder. This is dedicated to my beautiful daughter, Rima. And we put this in the show especially for her. This is entitled, Isn't She Lovely? We hope you like it. offerings on behalf of the band, sincerely from the depths of our hearts. May God bless you. May God keep you. That's all, folks. See you next time. God bless.